Laravel 11.22 is now out, and one of the cool new features is a chaperone method on the LQAP models, and that helps prevent like N plus one query problems. But what's cool is Taylor actually demoed this at Laracon. So why don't we let him show us how it works and what the benefit is?
Now, so what people will do is, you know, like they'll retrieve the users and they'll start looping through them like this. Users as user, and then maybe they like loop into the post for each user. And then here's where it gets a little gnarly. A lot of people want to try to do something like this. They'll go from the post back to the user, so like the parent user that owns the posts, and they'll access some data on that user. But let's see what database queries are happening. So I'm going to uncomment this DB listen. Okay, so now we're seeing the database queries, and you can see that we've got like an N plus one query problem going on. So after each email address, you're seeing how it's making a query to the users table every time we spin through the post. So for each post, it's going back to the user table, doing a query, pulling the user. Not good, right? This is a performance problem at scale. So how can we fix this? What if we want the parent user to be hydrated on the posts so they all share the same user instance, and if I update the user on the post, it's synchronized across all the posts? It's pretty tricky. People actually write some pretty gnarly code to make this happen right now. They'll do something like this. They'll say like users each set relation, or yeah, users each function user, user posts each set relation, user user. I hope this works. This is, okay, we resolved the N plus one query problem, but we had to write some absolutely atrocious code to make that happen. So let's get rid of this gnarly code. Okay, now we're back to our N plus one problem. What if there was a much easier way to solve this problem? It kind of feels like there should be. This feels like overly complex for such a simple use case. Well, now you can just come into the user model and say, you want these posts to be chaperones. And that's all you have to do. And it will hydrate the correct user onto the post. The posts will all be synchronized to their user. We actually prevent the infinite recursion now. So if you try to return this from the route, everything works really well. It works how you would expect. So much, much easier. And so you can chaperone these models in two ways. You can define it right on the relation like I did here, but you can also opt into it at runtime. So when I make this post query, let's do something like this. When I eager load these posts, I could actually like get the query here and say post chaperone. So maybe you don't want it to happen every time you load that relation, only sometimes. You could opt into it at runtime like this. So now if we hit this route, you know, we still see we've eliminated our N plus one query problem. And vice versa, like if we define it on the relation, okay, so we chaperone there. We can actually opt out, so we could say like without chaperone. And now we like reintroduced the N plus one query problem. But sometimes you might want to do that if it's a small data set and you want each post to have like a fresh instance of the user. So you can choose how you interact with this feature, but much, much easier to accomplish this use case without hanging your entire app or running out of memory or writing some really atrocious code. So that is chaperoned eloquent models.
So that is now in Laravel 11.22. It is now out. You can just run Composer Update to get this latest version. It also comes with other new features. Check our full post for all the details with links to all the pull requests. So that way you can dive in and, you know, check out any code changes or anything like that. But thanks for watching and happy updating.